Everybody. Ray is joining us 50? Something like that, yeah. Who's weird tasting? Who can jerk it and taste it? Who can jerk vegan jerky?
What nut?
Who works here brought that in?
Well, I don't know if the particular person brought it in or somebody sent it to that person, so I'm not going to call anybody out.
What do you think? People should eat food that's from their butt.
Well, it was fake packaging. You saw that?
No, it comes from the outside. You need the pet food.
Really? You're that worried? I didn't know that you were that concerned about things like that.
I know our audience. So you can get commercial items since you have to be a little careful.
Yeah, but think we packages the seal.
It could be interesting.
All right, well then, Ray, you know, you need to look for me for anything.
Well, interesting. That's good. Just jump right underneath. This story just came across this afternoon. It was back on July 8th, facing a recall and polling that didn't look so good for him. Governor Deputy D. Gavinson asked people to reduce their water usage by 16%. Well, here we are more than 3 months later and some of the numbers are in, and in Southern California, it didn't happen. Apparently, in Los Angeles and San Diego County, and I took a look at this, these numbers, on average, Californians reduced water usage by just 1.8% statewide during July.
Good.
As compared to the same month a year ago. And in Southern California, the drop is only 0.1%.
Mm.
And actually went up in L.A. by 0.7% and up by 1.3% in San Diego.
Nobody's listening to
me. No, the only place where water usage dropped was up in the real drought-affected regions up north. A few weeks ago, remember, it turns out the flexors are not being obeyed very much anymore. That they're
having the people.
Oh, the cutbacks of the power.
They cut back
their power between 4 and 9 o'clock, and it turns out every time they make another request, it ignored more and more.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, well,
they're up with that.
The volume keeps going down.
Oh,
yeah, they have a really sweet commercial on the Quest for Work contract. I saw this the other day. They tell you to cut back on your electrical use between 4 and 9 p.m., after that, there's more green energy available.
Lower, isn't it?
I
was going to say solar and wind.
Well, maybe it's before 4 o'clock.
Right.
There's more green energy available.
So that makes sense.
Which is but it's a really devious way of admitting that after the sun goes down, there's no green energy that you can use.
Oh, I see.
The sun sets, the wind stops. So, try to do your stuff before 4 o'clock.
With more green energy is available.
Like, in other words, you're using brown energy.
You're not using...
Yeah, I think I've seen that ad where it's like a little cartoon, was it?
It's showing how you can
you and your neighbors can help reduce energy use.
Yeah.
Somebody tell Newsom that once you close down the almonds.
They use just a lot more water.
Well, Mendocino and Sonoma counties are the two places that met Newsom's conservation target.
That's about it.
They're good progressive conformists.
Whatever the leader says.
So what now? Now they've survived the recall. He can come and do his water restriction without fear of losing the vote, right?
Right.
I'm curious if people they keep listening to this. But we heard this a couple of years ago, and nothing happened. And at some point, you can't keep... What they do is they yell about climate change every day, right? The world is going to end. It's too hot, or the winds are too strong, the storms are too big. Now, Biden went through a version of that today at the UN, right? And at some point, people get in the ear for it. I was reading a story today, and this was actually a left-wing publication here in California, and they're talking about the emissions, right? Global warming. And they said, look, truth is California's not doing anything.
It's
a little bit of it. But two-thirds of the emissions are coming from India and China. And, good luck with that.
But we knew that for years.
Right, but to actually see it admitted in print by a progressive writer, it caught my eye. Because it's the truth.
There's nothing we can do about global warming here. Nothing. And most of the problem is for China and India. And they'll just be an ever larger problem as time goes on, because they have so many poor people, and both governments are trying to raise the poor into at least middle class status, and you have to burn a lot of coal and natural gas to get there. There's no rule for it. I think this would be an opportunity for Biden to stand up there at the UN and tell China that you're going to have to cut back the global emissions and killing all of them.
No, they're terrified of China.
But anyway, he had the dark eyed look today. I watched a couple minutes of the news clip of him and Julian before the UN. I call it the dark eyed look that says Solomon is debating Trump. Did you remember the boyfriend call last week that said this had something to do with being drugged? You look like a skin around his eyes? No. All of the pupils, his actual black, his eyes are actually dark.
So the pupils dilated.
Yeah, that's right. Might be dry.
I don't know what that is, but I saw it again saying it creeped me out. I remember seeing that when he debated Trump last year.
Anything it creeped me out. I'm like, oh my god.
In bright light, the pupils now.
Right,
because they only can let in so much light, and if it's too bright, they have to reduce the amount that gets through the eye. But in darkness, they widen so they can take advantage of all the available light, however dim. So if he's got wide people in bright light, and I would think that the UN light should be brighter. But yeah, he's probably in trouble.
I mean, the eye color just looks black. It looks like the demon eyes is what I saw. It was like demon. It's weird.
Yeah.
Anybody 78 kind of autofills. I remember my father-in-law. At one point, he literally was laying on his sofa in Florida. And he was almost passed out. And we were trying to figure out from here in California what to do. So I got somebody to send a list of all the prescriptions. And it turned out he was on 13 different prescriptions. Because he got to several different doctors, and they kept prescribing, like, blood pressure pills and triple pills and heart pills and
triple
pills.
Yeah.
Right. And so every one of these pills slowed you down a little bit. And after you had six rounds of them, you're going really slow. You're barely breathing. And it's the thing like that, too. When you get to 78, you're on a lot of pills. And they all have side effects. In addition to your internal degradation stuff. One more note on the water. Southern California water agencies have been saying for some time now that they do have adequate supplies. So maybe that word got to people, they didn't care, and they didn't bother to cover, say, 16%. But it's easy to believe that somewhere around the corner here, Newsom is probably going to go with something, mandatory to fix they had to carry down the water. You'll see, this is what our COVID has taught all these control for. Frighten people, scare people, promote the big lie over and over, and eventually drop them off. So scare them we're running out of water, scare them that we're overheating, scare them that we're going to have blackouts. Just keep scaring them, and then people will comply. All right, we've got more coming up. 7:10 KFI, Deborah Marquez,
too. Compare COVID-19 vaccination rates among nursing homes. The agency says details are available through the Care Compare feature at Medicare.gov. A lottery ticket sold at a liquor store in Northridge was worth almost $486,000. They had five of the winning numbers, but was missing the Powerball number. And today is the last official day of summer. Ball starts tomorrow afternoon, so John, you better not wear a white tomorrow. Summer's over.
Yeah, I wear a lot of white.
On the 210, and we will check in with the KFI in the sky next.
Your home is your sanctuary, and in your sanctuary, where you are the ruler, you should have clean, fresh, delicious water. And you will get that with a life source, whole house water system, which is we have that in my kingdom. Every faucet in your house has fresh, filtered, delicious water, and this life source, whole house system is maintenance free, so you don't have any salt bags, filter changes, monthly exchange tanks, that was that. And if hard water is a problem, and you're sick of dealing with it, their system reduces their hard water issue. A life source water system gets rid of the odor and taste of chlorine without using salt or chemicals. So you'll no longer experience the drying effect of chlorine on your skin and hair. every time you take a shower or a bath. Call Extra today for full service, full confidence. 800-334-5009. 800-334-5009. FlashSourceWater.com. FlashSourceWater. Taste and feel the difference. Now through September 30th, lease a 2021 BMW 330i sedan for $429 a month for 36 months with $3,999 due at signing. See a Southern California BMW center today for details or visit SoCalBMW.com.
And this one is along the westbound side. It's just past McClay. That is where lanes are blocked. Kind of on detail, but we're just getting up, waiting for the higher to call to confirm which lanes are blocked. This is really messing up the 118. It's almost at the 210 westbound. Delays before the 118. It's starting to back up traffic on the 118 eastbound as well. We're seeing delays here. Not quite as slowing down from Paxton, but almost. And that is on approach to the 210. You see a county issue too with KFI traffic. Up to industry with Michael Bryan. KFI in the sky. Sponsored by Injury Attorney. Superwoman. Superlawyer.com.
Eagle fans off the field here on the 605. 605 southbound. Official scoring is just maybe the 60 interchange. Just coming off of Valley Boulevard. From there, it's going to be pretty choppy and pretty heavy most of the way through the 5. The Northbound 605, loading up there for the 105 and the 5, and that's all bumper to bumper. From there, though, it's more choppy, moderate and heavy up to the 60. Now, we still have a problem out in Ontario. That's the 10 westbound, just approaching 4th. It's just still in the far right lane, so this bumper to bumper right off the 15 out of Fontana. And doubles in North Fontana, Rialto, the 210 eastbound, just approaching Ayala. Looks like they're still in lanes there. Very tough, off the 210-10-15 interchange, I should say. Injured in an accident? Visit Superwoman, Superlawyer.com. Mike O'Brien, KFI in the sky.
KFI in the sky, not get you there faster. I'm Angel Martinez. This report is sponsored by Indeed.com. Thanks. Any bumps in your hiring process? Meanwhile, your reps are hired with Indeed. Their hiring platform makes it easy to attract, screen, and interview candidates. All in the same place. Find your next great hire and visit Indeed.com/credit.
With record low interest rates, is it still wise to pay off your home or has it become unwise? Wall Street says money never sleeps. Well, your home equity is in a coma. It's earning zero. Record low interest rates have created enormous opportunity for homeowners to borrow equity and move into alternative investments. It may have made a lot of sense when interest rates are 6 or 8%. It might be your highest priority to pay your home off. But with these record low rates, it's no longer wise. It's a timeless understanding that buying low and selling high is the way to gain wealth. How about borrowing low and investing in higher returns? Call HMS Capital today. With their razor-sharp interest rates, they're confident they're going to earn your business. No appraisal fees, no application fees. So phone them up right away. 833-255-5698. 833-255-5698. That's 833-255-5698. Or visit HMSCapital.com. I'm attorney Darren Cavanoghi from 1-800-NO-CUT. Can you do the alphabet backwards? Z-Y-S-W-Z. Yeah, try doing that by the side of the road. So if you get pulled over, don't wing it. Call us at 1-800-NO-CUT. Say you love or say my channel,
right? I like Valentine's Day cards to my solar panels, even when it's not Valentine's Day.
Next CDs together?
Absolutely. SolarMax has a brand new offer as well. They have the new Tesla 420 panels and power walls for $79.96 per month and zero down.
Call pound 250 from your cell phone and say that keyword SolarMax. Pound 250, say SolarMax, or go to SolarMaxTech.com.
Monthly payment available on food credit. CSLP number 972048. San
Diego, 10 to ride on the water from guest chairs in San Diego Hotel and Marina. With outdoor activities like yoga classes and paddleboarding. Save on their fleet estate to get 30% off fees this fall. Visit SheratonSanDiegoHotel.com and enter code HDK.
Attorney Joe Cordell. New school, new job, new home. Change is hard and can leave you feeling isolated. And divorce delivers one of life's hardest blows. The relationships you counted on are suddenly gone. But you don't have to walk through this alone. For more than 30 years, Cordell & Cordell has guided men through the challenges of divorce. You're not alone. call Cordell and Cordell.
Schedule an appointment with one Cordell and Cordell, California area attorney. 1455 Crazy Road, 3500 San Diego, California, 92108. CordellCordell.com.
At a prestigious consumer electronics show, the winner for best product might surprise you. Because of what the technology found in a mattress. Nameplate introduces a new smart life mattress by Camry. Inside every smart life is something revolutionary. 8 patented smart cells that create with personalized support and help you and your sleep partner adjust to comfort. Smart life even has a feature which number doesn't. A soothing relaxation mode that massages you to sleep or gently wakes you up in the morning. Before you buy a sleep number bed, you owe it to yourself to try Smart Life's revolutionary smart cell technology. Stop by any fitness store or make an appointment today, where you can shop safely with your own personal protector to lay on. And Fitness Place will deliver, set up, and remove your old mattress for free. So for the latest innovations in sleep, make the smart move. Try the new Smart Life mattress from Camcorp at Fitness Place today.
Join KFI and thrill seekers at the Afterburner Music Festival at the Pacific Air Show in Huntington Beach, October 1st and 2nd. This year's event will feature performances by Sammy Hagar and the Circle, Sam Hunt, X Ambassadors, and more. Get your tickets now at AfterburnerMusicFestival.com. KFI AM 640.
What's the name of the radio?
Talking about the migrants who have been camped in this something called the International Bridge in Del Rio, Texas. They're mostly Haitians. What I'm saying is the media didn't cover the aspects of their yesterday, that many of them actually came from South American countries where they had left Haiti to go to years ago, and that the reason they all came as well is because Mexico basically put out the green light and stopped throwing roadblocks in their way. Instead, all the coverage was about the fact that Border Patrol agents on horseback look like they're using a whip to control the Haitians. And apparently, what they did was they crossed the Rio Grande to try to get some supplies in Mexico, and then they wanted to come back to the encampment. And I guess the agents decided it was a good time to say, no, you're not crossing into the country twice illegally. We're going to try to defend you from doing that. Use a horse for the use. It turned out to be the reins on the horse is what people were horrified by, or the wickedness of it. But you know, it feels like, does anybody actually whip me now? I don't know. I can see the picture of one of the agents holding it. It's the reins, nothing yet, but it looks like a whip, but it's much thinner than a real whip. I don't know. These pictures were taken by sympathetic media members, disseminated around the world, and this became the big story to the point now where this is the only a huge investigation into this Congress.
Right.
Is that investigation into Joe Biden's idiotic administration to allow hundreds of thousands of people to cross the border illegally? No investigation into that.
No.
But I'm just wondering, is there a single illegal alien reporting that they were whipped? I'm just asking. I don't know. I wasn't there. And I can't tell from the pictures, it doesn't look like, well, like you said, it looks like the reins of the horse, not a whip, but I'm no expert on that. There isn't any video, I guess. Most of what they were trying to do is just block them. They were using the horse just to try to block them. They kept trying to run around the agents on a horseback. Well, most of the press is covering this one, so really, just when you look at an image, and, right, so they're willing to distort and exaggerate.
And then after the big story happens, nobody follows up and says, well, who got this?
I mean, where's the evidence? Even the Homeland Security Secretary, Mayorkas, wanted to make it clear that those are the horse reins, so they're not actual whips that the agents are given to whip migrants. I mean, that's a killer.
Does anybody believe that they're given whips?
No, that would be part of the equipment package. You can imagine that this is Texas, and looks like men on horseback, looks like the old southern plantation times, right? You hate men, they're all black, this is where people like us look at these images.
Yeah, but is that the reality?
Everybody can conjure up ancient analogies. This is what it looks like, but it's not. And besides, the best way, if you're running on open grassland, is to be on a horse. That's the most effective way to get around.
Yeah, and horses are pretty common. Even in New York City, they have horses. Horseback police officers for crowd control. It's supposed to be a good deterrent to get people to kind of move in a certain direction or not to
breach. Horses are used in all kinds of law enforcement, and the horses come with reins. That's how the law enforcement stays on top of the horse, by holding onto the reins. Then I want to get to the point where how do you even whip somebody, because the reins are attached to the horse.
Well, if you look at the photo, there's, I don't know if you're strong or
yeah,
if
it's the same picture I am, but there's a, I'm looking at an NPR story. You can see a border patrol agent who's got his hand halfway down the long rein, and he's got it, he's holding it out.
So it does kind of, it's much thinner and looks less menacing than a real whip, but you can hold it like a whip, sort of like just kind of holding it out. And, well, I guess who was asked about this? This ought to be good. The person that's supposed to be in charge of the southern border that was going to figure all this out, get our border policy back under control, Vice President Kamala Harris, here she is.
By the way, so do you have any reaction to the Border Patrol agents using horse reins to rein in Haitian migrants down the southern border?
What I saw about organizations on horse tracks, treating human beings the way they were, horrible. And I fully support what is happening right now because of thorough investigation.
And just as your role of, you know, sending migration from the from Central America, are you also going to be looking into, you know, looking at migration issues in Haiti as well?
Well, listen, the whole point is that we have to understand Haiti. I mean, talking about a country that has just experienced so much tragedy that it's been about natural disasters this year, that their head of state is assassinated.
Sorry. And you know what? These people are not directly from Haiti. Most of them left 10 years ago, and they went to Chile and places in South America. They went to various South American countries, and they built normal lives there. They got jobs, they had families, they were living in homes. They thought it was a wide open border to go to the U.S. They thought, hey, time for an upgrade, right? Let's move to a better neighborhood. So they sold their stuff, put their kids out of school, quit their job, and then went on this long march from South America to here. Now, that's an incredibly bad judgment, right? You're in a good place. You're in a relatively peaceful country. You're not having problems. And you decide you want better because, you know, Biden put out the call.
Yeah, we opened more signs. Supposedly, that doctor pointed Haitians, so they would have got that word and said, all right, well, that's the time to go. No more deportation flights. You're in the U.S. to stay.
Then they come to this country, and now they're being deported back to Haiti, and these people landed in Haiti. They've been interviewed and said, well, we don't know this country anymore. We left here a long time ago. We don't have anything here. And now they're thinking, okay, how do I get back to Argentina or Chile? They want to go back to their own life, their own neighborhood, and they're upset with the U.S. Well, wait a second. You had a good life. You barged in here. We sent you back to your country of origin. And you're mad at us?
We cannot take on everybody in the world who wants to come here. It just doesn't work. There's no room.
What?
We're going to destroy it.
What kind of crazy decision is that? I mean, think about it. They're not refugees. They're not coming from a place where there's violence and poverty and gangs and human trafficking. They had ordinary jobs. We're responsible for really, really bad judgment.
We're responsible for bad judgment. And the New York Times interviewed a bunch of them. They're decent life going in those countries. I don't know why they decided they had to get to America now.
Mm-hmm. One of these guys, his name is Nicodemus Bias, said, I thought the United States was a big country with law. They treated us terribly. Yeah, we do have law. Sometimes we go alien and get deported. That's what you were. Who asked you to come? He goes, he has been there for 18 years.
Thank you.